Kelman 009 at Delta 27, we are ready.
10.
Kelman 009, Delta 27, your startup is approved, 1-1 decimal 8.
As the sun sets or when the visibility is low, the aerodrome lights up, and when it does, it can easily fascinate you. But these lights are not just there to captivate you, they are there to ensure the safer operation of airplanes. From the light on the nose landing gear to the light on the runway threshold, each serve its unique and interesting purpose. So today in this video, we are going to talk about these lights in some detail. If we talk about the airplane, its lighting system can be broken down into two, internal lighting and external lighting. External lighting includes navigation lights, anti-collision lights, landing and taxi lights, and ice inspection lights. The requirements and characteristics of navigation lights are agreed on an international basis and are set out in the rules of the air and orders for air navigation and air traffic control regulations. Briefly, these requirements are that every aircraft in flight or moving on the ground during the hours of darkness shall display a green light located on the right or starboard wingtip, visible perpendicular to the first officer and making an arc of 110 degrees to the right. A red light located on the left or port wingtip, visible perpendicular to the captain and making an arc of 110 degrees to the left. The third requirement is a white light on the tail, which sometimes can be found on the trailing edge section of each wingtip of the horizontal stabilizer. These three navigation lights provide situational awareness to the cockpit crew. If they see a white light, it means that the other aircraft is going away from them. If they see a green and red light, it means that the other aircraft is headed directly towards them. If they see a white and red light, it means that the other aircraft is going towards their left. And if they see a white and green light, it suggests that the other aircraft is moving towards their right. In a situation like this, the cockpit crew seeing the red light must let the other aircraft pass, so they must decelerate, and the cockpit crew seeing the green light must pass, so they must accelerate in order to do so. Strobe and beacon lights constitute the aircraft anti-collision light system. Beacon is a rotating or sometimes flashing light. It completes around 40 revolutions per minute or 80 to 90 cycles per minute when it's flashing. It has low intensity and must be turned on before starting the engine and must remain illuminated for the remainder of the flight. It is red or white in color with a purpose to announce in the near surrounding that the engine is running or is about to start. Strobe light is white and has more intensity than the beacon but serves the same purpose. As their name indicates, these lights provide essential illumination for the landing of an aircraft and for taxiing it to and from runways and terminal areas at night and when the visibility is low. Landing lights are so arranged that they illuminate the runway immediately ahead of the aircraft, from such positions as wing leading edges, front fuselage sections, and nose landing gear structure. In addition to taxi lights, some of the larger type of transport aircraft are equipped with lights which direct beams of light to the sides of the runway. These are known as runway turn-off lights, their primary function being to illuminate the points along the runway at which an aircraft must turn to leave the runway after landing. Ice forming on the wing is threatening to every pilot because it can easily disrupt the smooth airflow over the wing, resulting into an enormous loss of lift. In those circumstances, stall will occur at much higher speed than the documented stall speed for an aircraft at a given flap setting. Wing scan light illuminate the leading edge of the wing to be aware of this deadly possibility. Logo lights are primarily for advertising purposes, but they also provide additional awareness in busy airspace to the air traffic controller. If you want to know about the internal lighting system used on an aircraft, consider subscribing. If you like the content of this video, do share your feedback with me. Remember that a good pilot or engineer or anybody in the aviation industry is always learning. Thanks for watching.